It's giving me 70s. It's giving me a 70s flower child vibe. But I like it. I like Hello. It. Hi, guys. Thank you for clicking on the video and welcome back to my channel. Y'all, today I was just doing this quick little eye look for an Instagram reel. And before I finished and decided to do my face, I said, let me just stop and go to YouTube because I wanted to talk to you guys about a brush set that I've been using. Y'all, as a beginner in makeup, when I first started wearing makeup, I didn't know anything about brushes. I went to Amazon, I bought one of those brush sets that had like 20 different brushes. I didn't know what half of the brushes were used for. So I have a lot of miscellaneous brushes laying around. I also bought a set from Target just because it was cute. Really didn't understand like what the brushes inside the kit were used for. I had never heard of a kabuki brush. Like, what is that? You know, in the beginning, I just purchased a lot of different brushes. Most of them are low quality, but I have been looking and searching for new brushes. And I came upon this brush set during the Amazon Prime Day. You guys saw it in my haul. It is the Real Techniques Everyday Essentials brush set. And this is for the face, eyes, and cheeks. So it comes with 1, 2, 3, 4 brushes and 2 sponges. And I wish someone had showed me this when I first started wearing makeup. Because really, for a beginner, this is all you need. I think this is a perfect beginner brush set. So I'm gonna go ahead and do my face using the brushes and talk to you about, you know, what each brush is used for, just in case you were wondering. Okay, now, so the brush set. I did purchase the brush set from Amazon, but you can probably get this anywhere. Ulta, you can probably get it from a drugstore. It was about $12, so very affordable, but very practical and useful, I think. And for me, I don't know if you're like me, but I don't like to have a lot of stuff around me. So that's why I said I wish I had found this earlier. So instead of buying a brush set with 20 different brushes, I could have got one with 4 different brushes and 2 sponges. And y'all, the Real Techniques sponges are really, really nice. They're soft. I did buy sponges from Amazon. I've seen people talk about those sponges and say, oh, the Amazon sponges are great. They're okay. They're useful, but they are not the softest sponges. But the Real Techniques sponges are nice, and I just imagine what the original Beauty Blender sponge feels like. But this is the packaging. I've been using the brushes, so I've taken everything out. But so it looks like this. I still have 1 sponge left in here. I've been using just the 1, and then on the back it tells you, you know, what each brush is used for. So I'm just going to go ahead and get started. I'm going to start with the first brush. This is the Real Techniques 200 brush. And this is a face brush. This is a foundation brush. You can use this to apply your liquid foundations as well as your cream foundations. So it has a firm brush. So perfect for applying foundation. So I'm going to be using a liquid foundation today. I'm using my Pat McGrath Labs foundation. And I'm just going to spray this directly onto the brush. And y'all, I do have on primer. I have on the Milk Hydro Grip primer. So as you can see how that just, this feels so soft. So soft. And definitely it can get all areas of your face. So you don't feel like, number one, it holds product really well. So you don't feel like you're wasting product. You don't feel like you're abusing your face. It just goes on really nicely. All right, so next in the collection is the Real Techniques 300 brush. And this, now it says this is for the eyes. You can definitely use this as a crease brush. It says it's a deluxe. So it says this is a short brush with dense bristles. You can use this in the crease for your eyeshadow. You can blend out creams like your concealer, or I guess if you're using a cream eyeshadow, or maybe even cream blush, but you can also build concealer with this. So yeah, so definitely for the eyes, you can use it. I did use it today with this eyeshadow. I did use it to blend, but right now I'm gonna use it to blend out my concealer. Go ahead and blend out the concealer. You can also use the sponge to do this, as I have found that a sponge is a lot quicker, but to me the brush gives a more precise and even and really nice blend. And it doesn't really take up a lot of the product. I feel like the sponge kind of picks up the product. But with a brush, what you lay down is what's going to be used. And it's going to stay there. And it's going to be distributed easily, evenly. I feel like when you use a brush, I don't know, to me, I also paint. And so it just feels like I'm creating a work of art when I use a brush. So again, the 300 Real Techniques brush, I used it on my eyeshadow and I used it to blend out my concealer. Yeah, I have a new t-shirt on. I love this t-shirt, but it's just really, it's kind of oversized. And but I'm wearing it today because I knew I wanted to wear my yellow eyeshadow, but I just feel like I keep pulling on it. But anyway, now we're going to go in with the 402 brush from Real Techniques. This is a brush, the bristles, so you have softer bristles, and this brush is perfect for powder, like setting your concealer. If you're gonna use some highlighter, you wanna just dust highlighter in certain areas, but I'm gonna use it to set my concealer. So let's go ahead. Ooh. See, and it picks up a lot of powder too, so. And I'm using the Laura Mercier translucent setting powder in honey. again, I feel like with the brush, you just really have more precise, more intentional application, and I like that. I'm sorry, you guys, I thought I was filming, but I wasn't. I'm also using that same 402 brush to do a little baking. Use this. So yeah, you can definitely use this for baking. All right, guys, so next we have the 400 brush. Now this is a big fluffy face brush. You can use this for your blush. It's really fluffy. You can also use this for bronzer. I'm gonna be applying my bronzer and my blush with it today. So I'm using the One Size Beauty 3D blush. So I picked up kind of a lot, but we're going to go ahead and just use this to apply the blush. I think it does a great job. You know, I don't have my pins to pin my hair back. You know, I just realized I didn't set the rest of my face. I did all of this. I set my concealer, but I did not set my foundation.
Oh well.
We're here now. All right, so. So what I'm going to do now, I'm actually going to clean this brush off, and then I'm going to... All right, y'all. So I did kind of clean the brush off a little bit, but I know it still looks like stuff is on there, but it is not. So I'm going to wipe off . Yeah, I love a fluffy brush. Just having a large, fluffy brush to dust powder over your face. Now we're gonna go in with some blush. So let me figure out which blush I want. All right, using the same 400 brush, I'm gonna go in with my blush, which is the Dior Rosy Backstage blush in the shade pink. It really doesn't look like it's picking up anything. So y'all, let me go ahead and fix these eyes, and then I'm gonna come back and wrap up the video. All right, guys, I'm back. This is my finished look. I'm feeling like a 70s flower child today. This look. I love yellow. It's one of my favorite colors too, as well as blue. I love a lot of colors, but I love playing with the color yellow. And And this look is courtesy of the Real Techniques Everyday Essentials brush set, along with one of their sponges. So the set does come with two sponges and four brushes. You have your foundation, the foundation brush. You have a brush that will help you blend out your concealer or blend out any other cream products you may have that you're using. And then you have, this is a nice powder brush, I would say, to set your under eye. I use this to set my under eye. And if you're going to be using highlighter, this would be a good one. And then you have the big fluffy brush. I use this to apply my bronzer and my blush. Today, also to just set the entire face. I use the sponge every now and then when I'm really in a hurry. But using the brushes, it takes a little bit more time, but I think you just get an overall better finish when you use the brushes, because they do help you to, I guess, be more intentional in your application. So yeah, it's also, it's for the face, eyes, and cheeks. And like I said, even with this brush here, I use this brush to apply the eyeshadow all over my lid today. So that is it. You can pick this up at Amazon, Target, Ulta, I believe I saw it at Ulta. It is the Everyday Essentials brush set for the face, eyes, and cheeks. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and get ready to get out of here and show. I'm not doing anything special today. I'm just about to go out to get something to eat. And yeah, so comment down below, let me know what you think. If you know of any other brush sets that are good for beginners, this is also a good travel brush set. I am traveling, so this is the only tools that I packed with me because I didn't want to have a lot of brushes. Y'all, I'm thinking about getting rid of my Amazon brushes and just move forward from here because I just have too many. So yeah, subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so. That's about it. I tend to ramble, so I'm gonna stop here and ask that you, if you haven't subscribed, go ahead and do so. Don't forget to leave a comment. And if you would be so kind, come back for the next video. And I'll see you.